Hey, what's up guys? Quinn here. So it's been a little while since you've last seen my classroom, so I'm really excited to finally give you some updates. So the 110 gallon show tank behind me here has been running for just under a year, and its transformation has been really fun to watch. I'll also highlight some of the other tanks in the classroom and hint at some plans that are also in the work. So let's dive right in. All right, so here was the tank a year ago. We started off moving Joker the Green Terror, Jack the Jack Dempsey, and my one convict cichlid that were initially in my 75 gallon aquarium. The tank proved to be plenty big for them, and they have really thrived in this new tank. I knew I wanted to get more fish to complement this trio, but wanted to make sure I picked the right ones. So last fall, I stocked the old 75 gallon tank with a mouth brooding severum, a firemouth cichlid, and four silver dollars. From the very beginning, the firemouth proved to be a total showstopper, as well as extremely aggressive. The severum took the brunt of that aggression and had a tough time to start. The silver dollars did well with the two aggressive cichlids and were left alone for the most part. After giving them a few months to grow, it was finally time to move some of them over to the 110 gallon tank. The firemouth and four silver dollars were the ones who made the move. So here is the current 110 gallon aquarium. So as you can see, the tank looks a lot different than a year ago. I was able to add a few more taller plants to contrast with the rock and driftwood scape. This also helps with line of sight breaks to deal with aggression. The new fish have done great in the new setting. The firemouth was about half the size of Joker and Jack when I added it, so I was confident that even with its increased aggression, the bigger fish would help reduce it. And I was wrong. This firemouth is just a total badass. The convict has done well with holding its own, but Joker has definitely colored down a bit with nipped fins in the past few weeks. Jack is the quiet tank boss, so he doesn't get messed with much. I absolutely love the color on this firemouth. The bright red to go with the colors of the Green Terror and Jack Dempsey really adds to this tank. The silver dollars also add a lot more activity to the tank, which I really like. They have tripled in size since I got them 5 months ago. So for those of you that have been following along since the beginning, you know that the Jack Dempsey is the OG cichlid. One exciting thing that I've kept secret is that his gene pool is still alive and in a variety of different teachers' classrooms around my high school. I had baby Jack Dempseys in a small 10-gallon aquarium and then had to give them away as they outgrew the tank, including the one I gave MBL Aquatics. One teacher was having issues with her tank, so she actually gave me one back that I added into the old 75 gallon to join the severum. Look at the color on this guy. My long-term plan with this tank is to add a female Jack Dempsey and have this be a breeding tank to continue this gene pool. The Jack Dempsey is my favorite fish, as with Billy Donovan.
You know what I didn't know about Billy Donovan? He loves fish. He's got a fish tank. The Cichlid brothers in Chicago built him a fish tank. And his favorite fish in the fish tank, Jack Dempsey.
So I love the idea of always keeping a Jack in my classroom. As with future plans for my classroom, I'm planning on replacing the 55 and 60 gallon tanks, both with 75 gallon aquariums. I plan on shutting down the 60 for good and moving the fish to a new home, along with Felix here in the 55. I'm just ready to try something new with these two tanks. Anyone have any ideas? If you do, make sure you leave those in the comments section. right, guys, so that's it for today's video. Make sure you subscribe so you don't miss any of those updates. We'll see you next time.